Back with you in Pittsburgh, the Virginia lineup with a 3-5-2 formation. Andreas Euland in the center, reigning defensive player of the week, the veteran center back leading the Virginia lineup. And for the Pitt Panthers on the other side, we look at Filip Mirkovic. He sets the tone for this offense. 5 assists this year, good for second in the conference, top 15 in Division I.
Going to be a lot of individual matchups tonight. Going to determine the outcome of this game. A lot of talent all over the field. A lot of different storylines to play out.
For the Pitt Panthers, we were curious to see where Valentin Noel, who missed last week's game against Louisville, would line up tonight. Looks like he is in the 9 spot in the center with Bertrand Jacquesson split out left and Rodrigo Almeida out right. Michael Sullivan gets a start tonight for the Panthers. He'll be in the midfield.
Early on, both these teams will be looking to settle into the play. The Panthers dressed in all white tonight, attacking from right to left. Virginia in dark blue, playing from left to right.
Two high-powered offenses coming into this game. Panthers with about 2.4 goals a game. It's good for top 3 in the conference. And for Virginia, they're in the same boat, the top 3 in scoring. So we do expect goals this evening, Dave.
Yeah, I think we'll certainly see some scoring. Both of these teams generate a lot of offense, scoring opportunities. Afonso himself is good for almost 5 a game.
Afonso with a great move into space. This one in front of net and a kick save there by Van der Sar. This one lined up by Virginia. It's still loose, and there's the first goal of the match for Virginia, and it's Philip Horton. After a scramble in front of Van der Sar, Philip Horton gives the Cavaliers a 1-0 lead.
What a start to this game. Dynamite for the Cavaliers, coming right in here and showing no signs of worry. You can see it's Afonso's release down the left-hand side. Beats Galena, squares the ball up. Horton with the initial shot, it's saved by Van der Sar. Saved again, but Horton again is able to capitalize. And the Panthers just can't clear it out, and Virginia brings too much into the box, and they're able to capitalize early.
What a start at Ambrose-Urbanek Field. Talked about how we expected goals. Virginia didn't let us down right away. Philip Horton with his 3rd goal of the year. That jumps him into the 3rd spot on the team. Philip Horton, a former understudy of Daryl DK, the Virginia great, makes an impact early on.
Well, and that's a huge impact on the road. This battle for first place in the Coastal Division. Both these teams 2-1. Duke not playing till tomorrow night. And we see Mohamed Abulnadi is down on the ground. Immediate concern on the face of Coach Vidovic and the Pitt coaching staff. Not only are they a goal down, but it looks like Abulnadi's coming to the sideline. And we'll see who looks set to replace him.
Panthers have been riddled with injuries recently. They had a stretch of 3 games in 7 days leading into that Louisville game. Jay Vidovich said they just really did not play well. They got outplayed by the Cardinals on the road. They didn't have Valentin Noel in that game. Guillerme Feitosa has been banged up. Lucas Rosa was dealing with some issues this week. And now losing Mohamed Abulnadi, who's really been a nice mainstay in the lineup for the in the back line for the Panthers. Here's where it potentially could have happened, maybe landing awkwardly on that right foot. Looks like he immediately grabs a left hamstring there.
It was chaos in that box early. Virginia attacking down that left-hand side. And you see Afonso causing problems immediately.
That was all generated by Leo Afonso, and he doesn't need much space, David, to be able to make something happen. Just about the width of a ball, George Gelnavach told us, is all Afonso needs to make damage.
I mean, he is such a dynamic player, chaos creator, intelligent player, and he's going to run his motor for 90 minutes today. He's not going to stop. He's going to continue to challenge these defenders all day long. And this game is definitely on. We'll see if Pitt's able to respond.
Virginia aggressive with the press. George Gelnavach told us he doesn't want to allow Pitt to be able to do what they want to do, and that's possess the ball, play out of the back slowly, and that press is showing high already, David. They're being even more aggressive now with a 1-0 lead.
Yeah, and that's the type of stuff they're going to be able to do now that they're able to come in and immediately pressure Pitt, immediately get them off their game. And you knew that was going to be the game plan coming in here. Aggressive, smart press. Fighting for every ball, and there's no surprise. So it's time for Pitt to respond. We'll see what they have. It's the first time we've even seen the Panthers in the attacking half.
Mirkovic lining this one off the crossbar. Noel with space, and that one's deflected by Euland. A corner for the Panthers, but what a flurry on this end of the pitch.
So immediately there, the Panthers asking questions. Mirkovic lines up and drills a nice shot on target, hits the frame. Dips down. Noel was almost able to get the rebound as well, but that was deflected out for the corner.
Mirkovic with service from the corner. Headed into the air and cleared out. Number 12 in white, Mateo Maiufo, has come on in place of Mohamed Abolnadi, who left with the injury a few minutes ago. Euland lets this go across the end line for a goal kick from Holden Brown. So, David, the first goal is always so important in ACC games, but especially here at Ambrose Urbanek Field. This year, when the Panthers don't score the first goal, they are 1-2-1. When they score the first time, they're 4-0. That dictates a lot of the ways that they play.
Yeah, and I think we've seen teams come in here and really try to disrupt their game plan, which is to establish their rhythm, establish their possession. Obviously, Pitt didn't even have a chance to put their foot on the ball with Virginia scoring so quickly, but you know that's going to be the plan of attack for most teams coming in here, to press them when they can, to disrupt them, to be aggressive with that press, but intelligent with it also. And look to force the turnovers from the Panther team and create opportunities for themselves. So I think for Virginia, it's an absolutely perfect start. They are rolling 4-1 in their last five.
Reese Miller to Afonso trying to head it in. The Panthers are going to try and counter quickly, but another great chance for the Cavaliers.
We were here for a non-conference game last week. Akron came in and it was a 3-3 tie, and Akron was up 2-0 until late into the first half before Pitt got a couple goals. So you have seen teams coming in here with a bit more ambition and causing more problems. Of course, Pitt has had to rebuild their whole back line and have a new goalkeeper this season. So every team has been looking to test those new players.
Pitt on this field since 2019, 26-1. With a plus 66 goal differential. They've been fantastic at Ambrose Urbanek Field. That first goal so crucial for Virginia. And David, one of the big questions that we had coming into this match was, how was the 3-5-2 formation with five midfielders for Virginia going to combat against the Panthers 4-3-3? What have you seen so far with that?
Definitely causing them problems, asking a lot of questions, finding opportunities to break the lines. Here again is Visa.
Visa trying to center this up. It just looks like Virginia in general has more life right now. Of course, you get energized by the goal, but right from the kickoff, it seemed like the Cavaliers were on a mission.
Definitely came with a game plan, attacking intent, disruption, and to capitalize on their opportunities.
Battle in the corner, Walty and Horton, two veterans.
We know it's going to be physical. Virginia fights for everything. They're definitely in resurgent form after having a couple down seasons. But they really contest everything. They do lead the conference in yellow cards.
Total goals for the Cavaliers this season. They had 23 all of last year. That 22 is good for second in the conference this season. So a real resurgent year. George Gelnavach told us they should be 6-1-2 at worst right now. But they sit at 6-3, 2-1 in the conference. A couple of bad losses in there. One in the final seconds to Notre Dame. One early draw to Xavier that they controlled for the entire match. And then a 6-1 thumping by Maryland on the road. And of course, beating number 3 Syracuse last week on the road. Virginia's well on their way. Here's Afonso now, dancing once again, creating space. This one's centered up, and Walty gets rid of it. He was looking for Horton again, though, was Afonso.
And that's twice now he's been able to beat Enrique Galena, twisting and turning. He was released down the line by Reese Miller. Here you see his feet cutting inside, outside, trying to provide the service to Horton, winning the corner.
Paul Visa will take it. He led the team in assists last year, only one this season. His 27th career start.
Virginia will be looking to make an impact on set pieces as well. They have some big boys that come up for these set pieces.
Visa sends it into the air, backside. And it's sent out there. Axel Ollander was on the backside of that corner from Visa. Ollander, the James Madison transfer, one of a few transfers for this Virginia squad they've inserted into their starting lineup that they've enjoyed. Axel Ollander, number 24, number 13, Moritz Kappelsberger. And number 5, Aiden O'Connor, who did not get the start tonight. We don't know if that's injury related or just lineup related.
And here you see Afonso now over here on the right-hand side causing problems. He goes left, right, he is everywhere up in that final third. And I'm sure he's going to be causing those pit defenders fits, trying to keep track of him. They're going to have to communicate effectively. They're going to have to stay connected. Afonso now heading back over to the left-hand side, but very problematic with his movements, tough to keep track of. They're really pinning Pitt back in their own half, and Pitt's having a hard time getting out. There Noel wins a free kick, and that's just what Pitt needs, really, to be able to put their foot on the ball and try to go the other way.
Enrique Galena, number 16 with the ball. Up the middle of the park, there's Euland cutting off Noel. Andreas Euland, the only member of this Virginia squad to play in the 2019 title game against Georgetown. Had a penalty kick goal at the end of that game in the shootout. Here's Pitt with their first somewhat promising build, but a little bit choppy, and they turn it over. Looking up top for Afonso again. Coming back the Panthers' way, here's Michael Sullivan. Trying to find Jacquesson, second in the conference in shots this season. Leads the team in goals. Centering this one up for no one. Back to Jacquesson.
Yeah, he was looking to make a connection in a box. It didn't pull off. Pitt still in possession, though.
Ball deflected on its way in. That'll be a Pitt throw-in. First time we've seen Jacquesson with the ball at his feet tonight.
Such a dynamic player. You can feel the energy in this building raise as soon as he gets put on the ball. He'll be looking to make an impact. You can't look away when he's near the ball.
Rodrigo Almeida doesn't have a tally this season, but last year was a big-time scorer for the Panthers. Second team All-ACC a year ago.
Yeah, he's been a little bit quieter this year. Not as much, I feel like, has been asked from him. He was filling in some big shoes last season. Another free kick for Pitt.
Axel Ollander taking down Filip Mirkovic.
It's Ollander, trips up Mirkovic, the ref's right there. Carmen Serbio there to make the call. He's going to be a busy man tonight. He's going to be challenged. It's going to be lots of physicality and decisions to be made.
Pitt really stretching their wings out wide, David.
They're definitely going to look to get in a rhythm, establish some possession, some patterns of play to be able to develop their strike opportunities.
Jackson Gilman, ACC Defensive Player of the Week a few weeks ago. Chipped up to Jacquesson. He's battling with Euland.
Newland's not afraid to get physical. As you mentioned, the ACC Defensive Player of the Week, the young Norwegian.
Pitt loses possession here. And Ewland is so impressive. Had a huge tackle in the second half of that game last week against Syracuse. One of Syracuse's best chances toward the goal. Had a tackle right at the 18-yard line when the game was still tied at zero.
Yeah, defenders can win your games too, and that was a tackle that definitely helped them win that game. Enabled Afonso to get the winning goal with 3 or 4 minutes left.
And it's been impressive watching Ewland kind of pace around with these Pitt forwards tonight. Stands at 6'5", 190. He's kind of battling with Valentin Noel, who's under 6 feet, around 5'8", and then getting over and covering Jackson as well, who's a little bit smaller than him, but it hasn't challenged him so far yet. He's been all over the place.
We'll have to keep an eye on that matchup and some other ones all across the field. Caught our eye early that Jackson was down here on the left-hand side as opposed to on the right, where he does seem to be a bit more comfortable, but Pitt's reshuffled their attacking players a little bit tonight. And I'm sure they'll give some different looks. Noel couldn't play that because he was in an offside position and encouraged Sullivan to continue the play.
Sullivan won the ball for a moment, but now Virginia with possession to Ewland in the center. No shots so far for the Panthers, as Virginia has gotten the better of the chances so far. Here's a beautiful ball up the side to Leo Afonso.
Now on the right side again.
Visa, nobody in front of him, lines this up. Had Horton there for a moment. Vandersaar couldn't keep it in.
That's a nice opportunity created there from Virginia, and it happened very, very quickly. You can see the big diagonal ball played there, finds Afonso. And this is what Virginia's going to be looking to do all night. He's able to cut it back. And here's the shot opportunity. Just fizzes a foot or so wide, but very dangerous, and a good opportunity for Virginia to get a second right there.
David, that ball came from Aspru Slavov in the midfield, and that's exactly the type of run that Afonso and Slavov hooked up on last week for Afonso's game winner against the Orange.
Yeah, it was similar in terms of the release of Afonso, but instead of accelerating towards the goal line, he cut in and was able to get a shot off on his left foot to beat the Orange, who were ranked number 3 at the time. That was a massive road win for Virginia.
Both these teams tonight, 2-1 in conference play, 6 points apiece. Tied for second in the Coastal Division. Duke ahead of them with 7 points at 2-0-1. They play at Wake Forest tomorrow. So the winner of this match will be in a good position halfway through the ACC schedule to take the Coastal Division.
Yeah, every one of these games now just seems so juicy, you know. I mean, just thinking about Duke and Wake Forest. You know, there was Clemson and Wake the other day. The game I got to watch, Virginia against Syracuse, was amazing. Virginia earlier in the season had a great win against Virginia Tech, which was excellent to watch. So there's just so many of these games that are so enjoyable. And I'm sure there's a lot of energy left in this one.
Jackson trying to put it high for Noel, and Ewland is able to clean it up, head it to his keeper.
Nice defensive header there.
Holden Brown, two straight clean sheets for him between the posts for Virginia.
I mean, if you're going to be a goalkeeper, it's not a bad idea for your name to be Holden. Because that's what you want the goalie to do.
Did we get your dad joke out of the way for this one?
One of them. I've got okay. A list of them okay. Here.
We're only 16 minutes in. There's too much time for you to kind of get on your soapbox with the dad jokes. Up the pitch now, Walty trying to keep it in, can't do it against
Walty there, trying to
Mangarov there.
Change the energy and momentum a little bit. We've seen Walty be able to change the course of games through his energy level, making a play, breaking something open. Valentin Noel does the same sort of thing. We've seen him just take their game to another level to be able to will their team, change the momentum of a game. So there's a lot of talent on this Pitt team. They're going to be very, very hungry to get a W. They're not going to let Virginia boss them around all night. So Pitt's going to have to continue to work the ball forward and create opportunities for themselves.
Here's Almeida dancing with it into the box. Gets it back. Flips fields here to Mayufo. In that left back position, filling in for the injured Muhammad Abolnadi, Chapman in the first couple minutes of this game. Centered up, there's Mayufo. Now loose, Sullivan lines it up and deflects it. Panthers maintain possession. Mayufo with more service. Try to keep it in, and can't do it.
So Pitt getting a bit more possession now, able to create a few more chances. Mayufo is able to burst his way through. Gets the ball across, but he can't connect with Noel, who he was looking for, and Almeida wasn't quite able to connect with Sullivan on the second chance.
Here's Sullivan on a run. Mirkovic. Mirkovic was inches away from tying this thing up at one. Hit the top of the crossbar early in this one.
Mirkovic is putting together a nice season. Had two assists against NC State, another two against Akron. He leads the ACC in assists per game. So he's doing very well. Can score some goals too, but they typically are those pile drivers from outside the box. You don't want to give them a yard of space on the top of your box, that's for sure.
7-3, the advantage in the shot department for Virginia now. And now Pitt's back line is up near midfield, and this is what they like to see.
Yeah, and you knew it was going to be hard for Virginia to sustain that early energy all the way through. So a little bit of a lull for them. They're going to need to continue to defend well. You see Euland again in the middle of the action. And again, they're able to work the ball forward.
Well hit the turf, no call on Euland. And now here's Leo Afonso with Green in front of him. Chooses to cut it back there to Mangaroff. And now Reese Miller. Reese Miller, a true freshman inserted into this starting lineup. They love his work rate. Played for the Houston Dynamo 2 in the MLS Next League. He's stepped right into that midfield and been a force for George Galinovac and the Cavaliers.
Yeah, they've looked for him a lot early, and even right there, putting Rosa under pressure. Virginia just seems to be first to most balls tonight, winning most of the 50-50 challenges and really able to get the ball forward. Pitt looking to build a bit more methodically. Virginia a bit more cutthroat about their business at this point in time.
Van der Sar wants a quick restart perhaps, and then he slows it up. Pitt has not lost in the regular season on this field in about 3 years. October 4th, 2019 was the last time they lost a regular season match here.
This place has been a fortress for them.
Said earlier, plus 66 goal differential since that loss in 2019 on this field. Joe Van der Sar had a great start to his season, David. 8 starts this year. 4 clean sheets early in the season, but he's had 5 goals allowed in the 2 starts before today, and now another. So 6 goals allowed in his last 3 starts, just 3 in his previous 6.
Yeah, I think some of the realities of the ACC play have come out, and also just the rigor of this schedule. Pitt really has challenged themselves with a lot of ranked teams early in their season. Van der Sar has been up to the challenge. He's really been solid back there. Had 7 saves against Louisville. But we'll see. You've got to be able to defend strongly in front of your goalkeeper. You can't just expect him to bail you out of every situation. He did make some huge saves in a number of games, and he has kept Pitt in certain games. So I'm sure he'll be up for that again tonight. They may need him to keep him in this one. Will help win it for him.
Even in that flurry, the first 3 minutes of this one, he had a nice kick save initially. And, of course, the longer the ball is loose in the box, there's only so much the keeper can do.
Yeah, you give away second, third chances, you're in trouble.
It's George Gelnovach, 27th season with Virginia at the helm. 357 career wins.
Really impressive tenure there at Virginia for Coach Gelnovach, really impressive.
That's Miller trying to center it up. Afonso was lurking. Slavoff gets rid of it. Man, what a coaching matchup we have tonight, David. George Gelnovach and Jay Vidovich, two of the best coaches in ACC soccer history. It's the 42nd time these two are going head-to-head. See some of the numbers here. Gelnovach with a 21-13-7 advantage. But how about that second line? 32 meetings by one goal or a draw was the decision.
Yeah, a lot of tight games in this matchup over the years. A lot of parity in this conference. Seems even more so these days. And you know, Pitt being able to turn the test of time and get good results in the last five. You know, Virginia's aware of that. They're looking to stop that run. Pitt has had their number the last couple years, and I think that that's definitely something that Virginia's looking to retake from them. For years, it was Virginia that had the target on their back. I remember Coach Gelnovach telling us nobody's going to feel sorry for Virginia soccer a couple years ago. And it's the same thing in terms of Pitt now. You know, everyone's going to be coming after them. They've beaten quite a few teams the last few years. People remember that, you know, and they're looking to get back at you as soon as they can. All of these guys, the players, the coaches, they're all extremely competitive. No one likes getting beat.
Pitt has beaten Virginia four out of the last five times they've met. One draw in there as well. But before that, it was Virginia, of course, with the better of the series. They went 7-0-1 against Pitt in the previous eight matches. So pendulum swung toward the Panthers a little bit, but of course you have to put some sort of an asterisk against that with Virginia going to the national title game in 2019. They lost so many players from that, David. And then into the COVID season, they lost people just going from the fall to the spring. So just now is when George Gelnovach feels like he has some of the pieces back where this can be an NCAA tournament team once again.
Yeah, I think it was really hard for him the last couple years, struggling. I don't think he really knew how to do that. It's not in his DNA. And so I think for him, the sooner he could get his team out of that predicament, the better. And that's where you see bringing in strong recruiting classes and some really experienced transfers that could help immediately. And you see what an impact it's made in a short time.
Here's Miller with a head of steam past Rosa. And look at Van der Sar coming out, making the play. No whistle on that play either.
Huge play, well timed by the keeper. Excellent effort. Yeah, I know Gelnovach believes his team is now a playoff team. He's not really sure what more than that they can be. They could be more potentially. Obviously, they've got the building blocks in place for a trophy, maybe in the next year or two. But they've got a squad that can do some damage, and if you're not ready to play Virginia Cavaliers this season, they're gonna put you on notice. Already coming in here at 6-3. They won only six games last year, 6-9-3. So a vast improvement from last year's squad. And you can see the results today, just how strong they are and the confidence they're playing here in Pittsburgh.
That COVID year was the first time Virginia had missed the tournament. 25 seasons, longest streak in Division I all time in the program, with 39 straight NCAA tournament appearances before missing it in the 2021 spring season. Missed it last year again, so this team already looking resurgent with the ability to get back to the playoffs.
Yeah, it wouldn't surprise me to see them back in the NCAA tournament this season. I look for them to, obviously, you know, they're doing well in the ACC. They were picked to finish last in the Coastal Division. That's clearly not going to happen. And so the question is, how high will they finish? And obviously, you know, with a win tonight, they could go top, as could Pitt. So everything to play for here.
It's Mayufo with a run, and Yulin takes a foul there. Just grabbed at the jersey of Mayufo to prevent the run up the sideline.
Yeah, it's a tactical foul there by Yulin, taking the chance. Mayufo had him beat, so he felt like he had no other choice but to commit that foul. So now he's sitting on a yellow card. And that's going to work in Pitt's favor. So they'll start to target him more and try to play off him more so that they can maybe entice him into taking a second one.
And he does have a menace matched up with him in Valentin Noel, who's going to run all over the place. This reminds me of our conversation with George Gelnavach when he told us, you know, that Notre Dame loss where it was a buzzer-beating goal. He said to us, you know, we learned something there. Maybe that's when you take a tactical foul before the ball gets forward, and that's exactly what we just saw here out of the captain against the Panthers.
But I would argue that wasn't the situation that Coach Gelnavach would have wanted Yulin to pick up a yellow card. So maybe at halftime it's that wasn't the right tactical foul, but who knows.
Here's Noel, first time we've seen him with any space around him. He wants to line this up. This one's in the back of the net. Valentin Noel on the score sheet ties this up at one.
What a goal by Valentin Noel. 25, 30 yards out, ran through the central midfield. Nobody stepped to him. Such beautiful placement. Precision. Galeen in the build-up play is able to find Noel. He's able to just kind of gallop through Virginia's midfield and just pick himself out a nice piece of the net to aim for that the goalie can't get to, and just slides it home from 25 yards. What a player. The leadership that he provides for this team, changing the momentum, getting on the score sheet, and this year he has just been a horse for this team. Absolutely immense, and that is a massive goal for the Panthers to get them back on level terms.
Jay Vidovich told us that not having Noel in any game, especially last week against Louisville, was crucial. He sees the game faster than anybody behind him, anybody on the pitch most of the time. That's his fourth goal of the year now, 28th of his Pitt career, one shy of fourth in program history.
And he's a guy that loves playing against the University of Virginia, averages a goal a game every time he plays him. He must just lick his chops when he sees the Virginia Cavaliers on the schedule. And that's a great response for Pitt.
Here's Afonso trying to take the lead again.
Challenge accepted, Afonso says.
Mayufo did a nice job of getting into Afonso. Here's Rosa trying to keep it in. He does.
And Virginia's made some substitutions now. Ubogu is on. Horton is off. So the tag team has begun.
Michael Sekulius, number 22, has come on as well. So Ubogu and Afonso, this is the first time we'll see them out there at the top of the Virginia formation together. Almeida trying to maintain possession. Doing yeoman's work there. Visa will get it back to his keeper. It's amazing, David, what Valentin Noel can do with just a little bit of space. He was kind of being harassed by Andreas Yulin for the whole night. Just really playing like a shadow. As soon as he gets some green in front of him, he took full advantage of it.
Yeah, and I think that's part of the adjustments that Noel's capable of making when he was pushing up high on Yulin, wasn't seeing much of the ball, wasn't having much success. So what does he do? He drops back down deeper into his own midfield, comes to find the ball, and is able to take a run and score a goal. That's a momentum shifter, and that's the type of stuff Valentin Noel does for you.
Mentioned before, he missed last week's Louisville game, got hurt in the Akron game. Two Mondays ago. He didn't even train this week until Thursday, so yesterday he's back out there starting with a goal early. This one's lived up to the hype so far, David.
Yeah, and I knew it would. I was really excited about this one. These teams are just so full of talent that it was only ever going to go one way, and that was going to be a blockbuster of a game.
Great crowd on hand tonight as well at Ambrose Urbanic Field, rivaling the biggest crowd in program history in the opener against Georgetown, with people lined all the way around the field. Coastal Division rivalry. Both teams with 6 points, sitting at second in the division. Duke at the top of the division with 7 points. They play at Wake tomorrow night.
Yeah, Coastal's just stacked right now. ACC in general. So many talented teams and players.
Here's Mangaroff, split out wide. Jackson, who now we've seen Almeida switch to the left side, Jackson on the right.
So Pitt's been able to settle in a bit better now. You've seen him establish a bit more possession of the ball. The game has become a little bit more settled.
There's a big collision with Maiufo and Citron. Citron getting into it with Almeida a little bit now. Service forward from Maiufo. Settles with the Pitt back line.
We definitely knew we'd see goals coming in this season. This game in particular, Virginia with 21 coming in, Pitt with 19 coming in. So both these teams in good scoring form. Both teams average over 2 goals a game, so we've got at least one more each coming. It's amazing how often that holds true as well in terms of teams scoring their averages, close to it. I remember watching the Akron game, we knew there would be goals, and there were 3-3.
Yeah, but in the same conversation, how many times do we think we're going to see something happen and it doesn't happen at all, and we get something totally new? So you could have just jinxed it. Maybe we won't get any more goals.
Yeah, right. I guess expect the unexpected.
No, this has been too fun so far and too open to think about a team not scoring again.
I'll give you another statistic that caught my eye was Virginia's been awarded 5 penalty kicks this year. They've scored 3 of them. Pitt has not been given a penalty kick yet this season. So, statistically speaking, they're due.
We shall see. There's been a couple that have been close. That was a nice job a second ago by Jackson. Try and maintain the run.
There's a foul committed there. I believe it was Noel.
Maiufo and Afonso getting into it. Here's good old-fashioned ACC Coastal Division soccer. Carmen Serbio has to come separate the teams.
Yeah, these players all know each other. They've competed against each other a lot over the years. There's history. There you see the foul at the top of the screen. Let's see what's going on at the bottom. Afonso kind of just tries to catch the ball. Maiufo's still playing a bit, and then they're sort of seeing how close they can get their faces to each other, I guess.
Something like that.
Well, boys will be boys sometimes.
Sometimes you just got to look a guy in the eye.
It's the challenge of the competition, you know. You want to play on that edge and really be able to maintain your focus while playing at a high level, lots of energy, intensity, and so, you know, all these guys are walking along that line, and it's one of the things that defines these players is their discipline. You know, they do so well in those situations and are challenged throughout these games. And even once in a while, if you see a guy make a poor decision, it is rare. And it's all learning and growth for all these players, so it's all part of their development. You want them to make the right decision, but they don't always.
Well said from the coach. A little bit more back and forth here in the last 10 minutes or so, David.
Yeah, I think Pitt will be the happier of two teams in terms of how things have settled down and for them to be able to get back into it. I thought Virginia had certainly the better of the first 15 minutes and could have scored a second before Pitt got their equalizer. So for Virginia, they'll be looking to re-energize their team, create more goal-scoring opportunities, get the ball forward more quickly, more effectively than they have done for the last 15 minutes or so, try to disrupt Pitt as they did early in the game.
It's Philip Horton who struck in the second minute of this. Then things kind of swung back in Pitt's favor, able to possess a little bit, and Valentin Noel found some space. Was able to tie this thing up at one. Philip Mirkovic missed a goal by just a couple of inches, hitting the crossbar just moments after that Philip Horton goal. Virginia's had a couple nice chances as well.
Yeah, we knew there'd be a lot of offense and scoring opportunities. Both of these rosters have players that have scored points. So Virginia has, I think, 15 players on their roster with a point this season. Pitt also with, I think, 13 or 14 guys that have registered a point.
On comes Josh Lucchini in for Rodrigo Almeida. He'll settle in at the top of the Panther formation. Lucchini kind of had his coming out party against Akron. And NC State had a couple of goals against NC State. Hasn't played more than 54 minutes this season, but he's a former All-American. He brings 27 career goals into this Panther lineup, a transfer in from Lehigh, Josh Lucchini.
Yeah, he knows how to bang them in, that's for sure. I used to watch his North United team play up at La Roche a lot, up on our field. And he's been scoring since he could walk, so definitely a nice player, local lad. It's nice to see him in a Pitt uniform after doing so well for Lehigh all them years, but it's got to feel good for him to be playing for his hometown Panthers for and getting a master's degree.
He's a fellow North Allegheny High School alumni like our producer tonight, Mr. Jason Earle.
Former teammates, apparently.
Yeah. We're being told that Lucchini is exactly five times better than our producer playing the game of soccer.
Jason Earle was a good little player as well. Well,
one of them's watching the game and one of them's playing, so I think that tells you all you need to know. There's Afonso trying to get around. Goes across the end line. Goal kick here coming for Vandersaar.
We do have to give a shout out to our Pitt Studios crew, producer Jason Earle, director Doug Shikitano, Reagan Check is down in there, and our stats maestro, Michael Masasich.
To Bogu, but he's taken down from behind. That's going to be a penalty kick. Didn't look like much at first, but Ubogu sold it for sure. Enrique Galina was in there. He's saying he wants a video review on it. You can review that this year.
Well, we'll take a look right now. You see the two of them tussling. That's all ball by Galina, to be honest with you, so I hope the ref does take a look at it.
And Ubogu just kicked the back of Galina, actually.
That's exactly right.
Didn't even make contact with the ball.
That's exactly right.
You just gave the number before, Virginia with five penalty kicks this year. It's going to be Leo Afonso to take it, apparently. Sure, Jay Vidovich isn't happy about this. And Ubogu's actually going to go to the sideline here. Leo Afonso with five goals on the year leads the team, tied for third in the conference with his teammate Ubogu. Ubogu draws the penalty kick. Afonso looks to finish it. So we're tied up at one at Ambrose Urbanic Field. Afonso against Vandersaar. Off the crossbar, it's loose, back toward the net, and it's over the top. The Panther faithful rejoice. Afonso couldn't complete the goal.
Afonso's just kind of stunned. He hit the crossbar. The keeper was sent the wrong way. Visa was able to follow up with a header, but that went over the bar as well. So Pitt is off the hook. You could argue justice has been served.
Massive moment in this match. Two balls have hit the crossbar tonight. Afonso right there on the penalty, and Mirkovic for the Panthers earlier. Could easily have multiple goals on both sides so far, but we're still knotted at one in the 39th minute. What a match this has been so far in the first half.
Always something. I mean, it's just incredible. You feel like the soccer gods just corrected the referee's mistake, to be honest with you, because I didn't think it was a penalty kick.
It's the first thing I thought of, to be honest with you. And I didn't say it, but it was running through my head. You know, that's sort of soccer justice, if you will, just because of the circumstances of that.
So Virginia asking a lot of questions again. That's a bit of a let off for Pitt, really. Obviously, we felt the penalty kick award was hard, but harsh. But I wouldn't have put money on Afonso to miss that.
No.
And so they've been let off the hook a bit there. It's going to be important that they don't let up. We'll see if there's more goals before halftime, or if teams are able to make it into the locker room for halftime adjustments.
Slavov running on, blocked there by Gilman. He stepped up. Hollander off the back of Afonso. He maintains possession. Centered up right there looking for Slavov. That was Galina stepping up. Now he's going to go on a run up the middle of the field. He's feeling a little bit of juice after that foul in the box. Here's Noel out left. Visa in there to take it away.
Galina galloping forward from the center back position, the USF transfer.
Galina, part of that revamped Pitt back line, lost all four starters from a year ago. Here's Mirkovic in a dangerous spot. Now Sullivan. Lucchini. Back to Walty. Under five to go in the first half. Jacquesson lining it up with the left foot save there by Brown.
Nice shot taken by Jacquesson. You could see him kind of drop his shoulders and turn in. Puts it on his left foot, which he's equally as dangerous with, but Holden Brown makes a good save. Is able to push it away. So Galina's definitely had a busy first half. He's been tortured a bit by Afonso. He's given up a penalty. He's had a galloping stride, so he's definitely got his juices flowing today.
Now that this settles with Holden Brown, just before the penalty kick, we were trying to give a shout out to Michael Masicic, stats guru down in the control room. We've been trying to do it for a couple games, but he helps us a ton with the research, and we appreciate it. There's Galina. He said it. Feeling the juices. He's going. He's into this match.
It was a dashing run from deep in his own half all the way up.
You don't see him do that very often. He's usually the guy to settle things at the back of the formation and kind of kick it around, move the defense side to side, and you can tell he was just kind of feeling it.
Well, you can see some of the emotions flowing in this game. You know, they don't always froth to the top, but certainly today has everything, and it's going to be an exciting second half, that's for sure.
Great clinical passes right there from Virginia to try and give Slavov a chance. Nice touch from Ubogu in that little run.
Yeah, nice combination play there. Virginia had a tough game at Syracuse last week. We talked about that, but they didn't have a midweek game, so they have been able to rest and recover somewhat.
Michael Sullivan into the starting lineup for the Panthers tonight. What have you made of his performance so far?
Really strong in terms of the energy he's bringing, challenging, trying to create and bust things open for the Panthers. I think that's really what Coach Vidovic was looking for him to inject into the lineup.
Here he is with a nifty spin move in the box, and he's taken down. No call there. Right on cue. It's his second start of the year. Started the Marshall game earlier in the season. Also a local guy.
Yeah, Sully's done well with his opportunities. He's worked his way into up this Panther depth chart and become a key member of this team.
This one line to Lucchini, trying to connect on a header from Rosa out wide. Now Mirkovic. Looking to make a move. Back to Walty now. He gets it into Maiufo with space right into the arms of Holden Brown.
Good work there. Maiufo kind of got it stuck under his foot a bit. I thought he couldn't get the shot off that he wanted. But it was a nice through ball and a good opportunity created. But again, Holden Brown was there to keep the Panthers out.
Remember that Maiufo is into the lineup right now because the starting left back, Mohamed Abolnadi, had to leave the game in the first couple of minutes with a leg injury. Maiufo stepped in nicely. Mirkovic couldn't get a foot on that ball. Great ball up the side here to Afonso. Defended by Jackson Gilman, the freshman. And Afonso will kick it back. Afonso fresh off of a penalty kick miss off the top of the crossbar.
And we'll see if that affects his game tonight. Sometimes that can make an impact on a player. He's had a really good first half, so hopefully he doesn't let that affect his confidence.
First half concludes. We are tied at one at Ambrose Urbanic Field. David, this one living up to all the hype. We knew it was going to be a dogfight. Coastal Division rivalry, this has been fun.
Yeah, it's been great. Can't wait for a second half. Obviously, we've had a bit of everything. Really bright start from Virginia. Pitt was able to dig their way back into the game a bit. Noel found themselves a goal. And I think we're really perfectly balanced for a second half. It'll be interesting to see what adjustments the coaching staffs that they had to regroup after that. They took a hit, but they've responded well and the game's back even. So we'll see what happens for the second half.
Virginia with a 10-6 advantage in the shot department. We're set to go here in the second half. Valentin Noel back once again after being held out against Louisville last Friday with a leg injury. He looks like he's back in his form with a big goal tonight. It's amazing, David, still marveling at the former Mack Herman finalist from a couple of years ago, and Valentin Noel was having so many problems early on with Andreas Ulin, just not being able to find any space, and somehow, once he gets a little bit of daylight, able to put it in the back of the net.
Yeah, Noel's really been a scrapper, doesn't give up. Perseverance is just incredible.
Here's Ubogu, who was down right off the restart here. From behind, it's Maiufo. Looks like he took a bit of an elbow in the back, so it's a free kick that he's won in the attacking half for the Cavaliers. Ubogu starts the second half. This is what George Gelnavach usually does with him, brings him on midway through the first, leaves him on in the second, gives him a blow, and then we'll see him again to end the game. They love that combination with Leo Afonso.
The Mangarov's getting set to deliver the set piece. Virginia will be looking to get on the board again early in the second half.
Ball doesn't go anywhere, headed out by Pitt. Out the backside, this will be a goal kick for the Panthers.
In terms of halftime adjustments, I see Jack Eson has started on the right-hand side this second half with Lucchini staying on and playing on the left-hand side. Noel remains in that number nine position up top for Pitt.
Maiufo, still at the left back spot. Mohamed Abolnadi left early in this match, the starting left back for the Panthers with a leg injury, came down awkwardly after jumping in the box.
you know, Coach Vidovic will be looking for Pitt to start with a lot of energy and be able to maintain it. He'll be looking for them to put their stamp on this game through their play in the second half.
That was a great job by Galena to keep that away from Afonso. It was potentially dangerous. Jacasson combines with Noel here, the French connection. They win a corner out of it.
Both these teams have really scored a lot of goals in the second half this season. Virginia exploded for 4 in 13 minutes during the Virginia Tech game. Certainly late goals at Syracuse and Notre Dame for them.
This one headed on the backside, but too high. That was Gilman coming in from the far post.
See the delivery from Markovic. Gilman getting up. He was challenged and wasn't able to get a clean head on it. Goes out for a goal kick. You see Gilman there, the center back, having a really bright freshman year for Pitt. He's started every game, played just about every minute that I can think of, so he's really come in and shown that he can play a lot of positions across that back line and that Pitt really can't afford to take him out of the lineup.
The luxury for him is they can move him to any one of those backline positions, depending on need. Challenges Ubogu right there. Virginia wins a throw-in.
Getting himself some assists as well, so contributing at the front end as well as helping to keep things tight at the back.
Last time these two teams met was in Charlottesville a year ago, went to a double overtime draw. Will Citron was able to put a goal in with 6 seconds left. Pitt had a late red card in that one. You know, Jay Vidovic wasn't too thrilled about the way that game went. But it did end in a draw, and it looks like we could be going that way tonight. Right down to the wire between these two teams. This one cut back by Seculius, and that'll be a goal kick for Van der Sar.
Well, we'll see what happens, but one thing I'm certain of is there will be no overtime.
That's for sure. New rule this year, no overtime in the regular season, play only to 90 minutes. And then in the postseason, you play both overtime periods, no matter what. So you can have multiple goals, no golden goal anymore in college soccer.
I'm curious to see if either of these teams can take the game by the scruff of the neck. It's been a pretty open start to the second half.
A couple of big collisions with Mayufo and Hollander over there. Jacasson, Seculius battling. Jacasson winning possession, cuts it back. Just a clinical display there to even maintain possession for as long as he did.
Okay, wins a throw-in, and Pitt's going to be able to establish some possession in the opponent's half of the field. One thing Coach Gelnovac talked about with his team, they have not let down in any match. They work for 90 minutes. They keep going for 90. You see Afonso there chasing down Mayufu. They got a team full of guys like that that are going to give everything they have here tonight to try to get this result.
Cini wasn't able to handle that pass from Mayufo, so a turnover there. That's one thing you talk about playing a full 90 minutes that Jay Vidovic and the Panthers have been kind of looking for. They've kind of been putting 45 minutes of a game together here and there. First half against Louisville was very slow and sluggish. It came on a little bit in the second half, but really one of their worst games of the year. Started slow in the Akron game, ended up coming back and getting a draw out of that one. So that's been a theme to the year, but tonight it looks like outside of the first couple of minutes, they played fairly well in that first half, and they're looking to make some things happen here in the second. Here's some daylight there for Noel off the ball from Lucchini, and that's a corner kick for the Panthers.
So we'll see if Pitt's able to get something established. See Walty getting it up the field. Lucchini getting it into the box quickly. Noel's the target, but it's cut out. A little bit of pushing and shoving in the box there.
Third corner of the night coming. It's Filip Mirkovic, 5 assists this year. Goes short this time to Jackson. He'll serve it into the box. That one was flicked on by Sullivan, but it goes out the back.
Gilman couldn't quite connect with it at the back post. You see here, it's Jackson delivers. Sullivan gets his head on it, and it just whizzes across the face of the goal. So no damage there. Pace of play slowed a little bit. Not quite as end-to-end as it was in the first half so far. I think Virginia kind of lost the momentum of their bright start. You know, they scored so early and weren't able to get a second. And as the game wore on, Pitt's been able to get more of a foot in and establish more of the rhythm that they want to establish, play more of their game. And so Virginia's going to have to find a way to get the momentum back in their favor. Right now, Pitt just seems to be spreading them out a little bit easier, a little bit more, asking a few more questions. And here comes Jackson.
Split out right, up top again for Mirkovic. Left-footed service, nobody there. You talk about Virginia kind of losing momentum. I mean, a great way to lose momentum is missing the PK. That had to be a real gut punch for Leo Afonso and his teammates to not see that ball go into the back of the net. It's now behind the play. I believe that's Valentin Noel. Noel coming off an injury, missed last week's game. Went down in the Akron game, played only 51 minutes. Here's a look at what happened to him.
He kind of runs into Yulin's face, and Yulin's got that nose guard on there, and it looks like he just kind of run into it.
Yeah, it doesn't look like anything on the lower body, which was the injury that he had to sit with. So it looks like just getting a little bit of a knock here off the mask of Yulin. Sure, he'll be able to continue. Walks it off.
That's a tough situation because I'm sure it's no fun for Yulin to play with that thing on either. And it's almost kind of unavoidable just in the run of play in terms of how he turned and just it was a coming together of faces or heads, whatever you want to call it. Looks like the ref's going to look at a replay to see if there was any malice there. But to be honest, we didn't see any. So this is one of those instances where you can do a video review, although we did learn that you can't review the penalty kick like we'd maybe thought they could.
Yeah, that Kome Bogu foul that he drew in the box on Galena, I said that they could review it. Now they can review whether the foul was committed in the 18-yard box, not whether it was a foul or not. So that's a clarification on that rule for you, but... And it's worth noting here as well that the officials here do not have these replay looks. They have a self-contained system with cameras around the facility. So here's a look at what can be reviewed. You see the one at the bottom there, whether a foul occurred inside or outside of the penalty area, not whether it was a foul. So this one here wouldn't obviously result in whether it was a foul or not, but nothing there.
That's right.
No malice.
He's had a look. Nothing there.
Official Carmen Serbio tonight. He's done a pretty nice job. It's been a little chippy at points, but he's done a decent job of maintaining control of this one.
Yeah. Hasn't got out of hand at all.
Obviously the big question on the Bogu play, but aside from that, fairly even calls.
Pitt likes these deep build-outs from the back. It's commonplace for a lot of teams these days. Walty getting forward there, looking to get his foot on the ball.
Rosa sending it forward. That was a good job by Kappelsberger to kind of cut off Jackson, who was sprinting straight on.
We'll see if Virginia's able to pick up the energy level. They seem a little flat to start the second half. In the first half, we saw a lot of big diagonal balls that they were able to chase after. A lot of play out wide. Haven't seen them be able to reestablish that in the second half so far. Pitt definitely finding more space and having more time on the ball.
Mirkovic head of steam here, top of the box, leaves it for Jackson with tons of space, lines it up with the right foot, and it crosses through everything. Great chance for the Panthers and can't capitalize.
Yeah, it was a really good opportunity created. They looked like they had Virginia spread out a bit there. Mirkovic is charging through the midfield, looking to connect. Ultimately finds Jackson, who whizzes one across the face of the goal. Sullivan can't quite get to the back post to tap it in. I wasn't sure if the goalie maybe got a finger on that, but it must have just missed it. But there again, Sullivan looking to get on the end of it. Jackson using his speed and his finesse to get the opportunity. And Pitt certainly looking better so far in this second half. We'll see if they're able to capitalize on stronger play coming out. I know that Coach Vidovic was happy about the fact that they're further along than where they were last year. While they've had a bit of an up and down week, they've, you know, had three straight shutouts during this season. They're making progress every time out. Again, we talked about even though they didn't start great today, they have been able to establish much more of their will on the game since falling behind. And he's been impressed with the efforts of his guys every time out.
Everyone pleading for possession there. Yeah, I mean, he mentioned that, like, you know, we it's amazing what's happened with Pitt soccer in such a short time where, you know, years ago, a team that was a doormat in the ACC to now they lose one match against Louisville and everybody's kind of like, oh, man, like, what's going on there? But, you know, the reality is that Jay Vidovich kind of leveled this out. And he said, you know what? We're further along this year than we were last year. Last year, you know, we didn't play Georgetown. This year, we beat them. Last year, we lose to West Virginia. This year, we beat them. So he's proud of those few things where you can look at that record at 5-2-1 and say, yeah, I mean, you beat number two, you beat number six. Got to be happy with it regardless. And then, obviously, the ACC is a whole blank slate. And you don't know what's going to happen from week to week.
Yeah, but it's important that you remember that it's all about building, continuing to build. Obviously, you establish the foundation and you build up from there, establish your culture.
Horton with a chance there, but Van der Sar coming up off his line to take it away.
Very few teams win every single game they play. Even right now, Wake Forest 9-0. I wonder what Bobby Moose would say about his team. I'm sure he feels there's things they can improve upon. So most of these coaches are never satisfied, but also you've got to realize it's a marathon and not a sprint. And it's all about where you finish and the journey that you take to get there. And sometimes that involves suffering together.
George Gelnavac told us the same thing about his team. You know, he knows that the building blocks are there to be a postseason team this year, but, you know, to what degree? That kind of depends on how this season builds along, how these guys gel together. Can you be disciplined enough to eliminate some of the small mistakes so that when the end of the year comes along and you're playing in big moments, you can avoid those mistakes?
Reese Miller was trying to find Afonso there. Afonso's been really quiet this second half, whereas he was absolutely lightning throughout the first half. So whether Virginia's just not able to connect with him as much, or he's not able to find the ball as much, or if his confidence has been shook from the penalty miss, we will see. There they did find him, but he was returning from an offside position and the AR's flag went up.
Talked about how this is the 42nd meeting between George Gelnavac and Jay Vidovich, two storied ACC coaches. Vidovich, the only coach in ACC history to win over 100 matches in conference play. Gelnavac just behind him with 97. And this has kind of been a tactical chess match between those two tonight.
Yeah, I mean, those two are just legends of the game. For me personally, we're spoiled being able to talk to these coaches every week. Jay Vidovich there with 7 ACC Coach of the Year awards. Back to back the last 2 years here at Pitt. Very impressive what he's been able to do with University of Pittsburgh soccer program.
Walty looking for Jacquesson and a turnover in the midfield. Here's Kappelsberger trying to ignite a counter with Afonso. He switches fields. That's Visa out there into Horton. Horton with a goal tonight. Second minute of this one, third of the year. Now look at Noel going right at Euland.
Yeah, it's been a nice tussle all night long between those two. Both of them going hard, giving it everything. And they've been going up against each other for a few years. So as we said, they know each other very well.
Here's Horton coming up into the 18-yard box. This one lined up by Miller, and there's a goal for Virginia.
Great finish there by Reese Miller. Excellent build-up play by Virginia. Philip Horton really causing a lot of the damage, was able to bring the ball into the box. You see the chance created here. Look, that's where Horton picks the ball up. He's able to run at the pit back line. Can't quite find a way through, but he finds Afonso, who's able to get it to Miller, who takes it very, very well to beat Van der Sar. Strong play by Horton there. Delicate touch. And a delightful finish. Virginia back in the lead. Against a run of play, they've been able to snatch the momentum back. Reese Miller, the freshman, putting his stamp on this game.
First career goal for Reese Miller. What a touch by Afonso to set him up as well. Afonso with 2 assists on the year now.
So there's the response for you. And despite Pitt's brighter start to the second half, they've basically controlled the ball the first 15 minutes, but Virginia's took advantage of the opportunity that they created. Good connected play up in the opponent's penalty area. They were able to strike gold and take a 2-1 lead.
What a fantastic build-up there from Virginia as well. Quick combination passes, Horton doing yeoman's work with the run-up. And Afonso, just a gorgeous touch. Can't say enough about that. And it just felt like in the second half, David, that Pitt had most of the control of possession. They felt like they had control of the match at this point. And then Virginia, quick couple of passes, and all of a sudden, it's 2-1.
Yeah, and that's the level of talent in this conference, is that anyone can hurt you. Reese Miller never scored a goal before, but he's in the right place at the right time, and he knows what to do with it because he's got the talent and he's got the technique and the touch. And he wasn't scared off by the big moment. Slotted at home. Gave his team the lead.
Product of the Houston Dynamo 2 in MLS Next Pro League. 3-star prospect coming out. Rated by Top Drawer Soccer. Pitt wins a free kick in the midfield here.
I think it was a handball on Afonso.
Sir.
Then Walty wanted to take a quick free kick and he kind of jammed him up. Referee had a word. So now we'll see if Pitt's got a response. They don't seem panicked, but there's a bad turnover. The chess match continues. We'll see if Coach Vidovich has a response to try to get Pitt back on level terms. If one of his dynamic players has a beautiful football action to get the ball into the back of the net and get Pitt back level.
Thanks so much, everybody, for being with us tonight. Kevin Wheeler and David Day here on the ACC Network with you. 2-1 Virginia, 64th minute now.
And Virginia scoring their 15th second half goal of the season. Just, they had 7 coming into today in the first half. 14 in the second half, just added their 15th. That's a lot of second half goals. And if they're able to get another one at this point in time, Pitt's going to have an extremely hard time recovering from that. Reese Miller turning this game back on its head. We'll see if Pitt has answers.
Rodrigo Almeida. Here's Mirkovic. He turns it over. Pitt with 11 second half goals of their own. Virginia coming in hot, won four of their last five. Panthers had a winless week last week. Here's Breton Jacquesson, and he wins a corner out of this one. It'll be corner number four for the Panthers, just the fifth in the game overall.
Walty picks him out, plays the ball over the top to release Jacquesson. Good recovery.
It's Kappelsberger.
Moritz.
Mirkovic with service on the corner. Headed toward the goal, kicked out there by Ulund. Now it settles once again with Mirkovic. And he wins another corner. He wants to get out there quickly.
Looks like Gilman took some sort of knock there.
Yeah. Carmen Serbio whistles clock to stop. Gilman number two in white there. And yeah, just took a knock with Horton. Kind of head-to-head collision.
Big stop there by Ulund to get behind the ball. He's been everywhere tonight. Really anchored that back line for Virginia.
Two stars of the game right there. Valentin Noel, Leo Afonso. Afonso, five goals on the year. Noel with four now after his goal tonight. Mirkovic with five assists this season, goes short this time to Almeida. Back to Almeida. And he loses it across the end line. It's a big mistake there for the Panthers, having a couple of corner kicks deep in their offensive zone. They lose possession.
Yeah, I think they had a specific set play there they were looking to execute, and it broke down a bit, so they didn't really get what they wanted out of that. But good defending again by Virginia. They're pressuring everything. They're not going to let up. They're going to keep coming and keep coming and keep working to try to prevent Pitt from getting the equalizer. See if they can extend their lead themselves. Pitt's been out of their rhythm since Virginia scored.
There's Miller trying to tack on another one. Giving chase, putting Vandersaar under pressure. Walty trying to win the ball up against Mangaroff. Be Virginia throwing. Jackson Walty after tonight will have over 7,800 career minutes in his college career.
Coach Gelnovac said he felt like Walty had been at Pitt for 20 years. So I think it's only been five, but that's the type of impression he's made on people.
Two-time All-ACC in Walty's career.
Walty definitely a huge player for this Pitt team. They're tallies, man. Feel like he's their soul in some regards. Never lets them quit. Keeps them working, keeps them on point.
Just think about how he was a walk-on and how at the end of this year, you know, he's going to try and go and play professional soccer most likely, and he's just turned himself into something. It's impressive the discipline he's been able to showcase in his career.
Massive.
Lucas Rosa trying to ignite something here for Pitt. Down 2-1 Virginia with the goal from Reese Miller. First career goal puts the Cavaliers up 2-1. Mirkovic and Jacquesson combining. Jacquesson cutting it back. That was against Miller. Tried to center it. Now Rosa. He's looking back post. That Euland. One's lined out there by Citron.
Euland again cut it out. And while Pitt still has possession.
There's Euland once more. And Afonso wins possession for his side.
Pitt's going to have to figure out a way to get around Andreas Euland. He's been jamming him up tonight.
It's like there's three of Andreas Euland out there. He seems like he's around every ball. Here's one into the center there. Big collision in the box. That was Afonso trying to combine with Horton. No call. Play continues.
I didn't see Horton kind of appeal too much, but the Virginia substitutes definitely wanted a penalty kick there.
Here's Jacquesson in the middle of the park this time. Tried to thread the needle to Lucchini, but he gets possession back. Into the center, Noel. Euland once again, who else clearing it out? And Noel showing a little bit of frustration right after the play. Here's the play with Horton on the other side.
We'll see what happens here. A bit of a tussle, but certainly not a foul of any kind.
That's Miller down on the turf. Here's the last pitch chance with Jacquesson. Barely misses getting it through to Lucchini. And this one looking for Noel. I love that look right there at the end. You see Euland's confidence. Valentin Noel showing a little bit of frustration for the first time.
Well, the resolve of this Pitt Panther team will definitely be tested here tonight. Virginia giving them everything that they can handle.
Three goals in the match tonight. One coming just a few moments ago. Here's the first of the night. Flurry in front of the net. Finished eventually here by Horton. Then we look at Valentin Noel. He's been struggling with Euland all night long. Gets a little bit of space in the first half, and he puts that one in. Make it 1-1. And then right here, a beautiful layoff from Afonso to Reese Miller. And Virginia up 2-1. Miller goal coming in the 61st minute. And now Miller leaving the game.
William Citron coming on to replace him.
Cooley is coming back in. So right now, Miller could be the hero. It's about 20 minutes to play in this one. Good touch to Rosa there. He's going to switch fields quickly to Mirkovic. Tries to leave it for Jacquesson. Can't do it. And on for Pitt now is Noah Hall as well. Noah Hall has come in for Josh Lucchini. He's at the top of that formation. Split out wide right, number 13 in white.
Yeah, I wondered if we might see Noah Hall tonight. He's been doing really well for Pitt as of late. He's really picked up his level of training, been given an opportunity, and he's taken it. He scored a big goal against Akron. Doesn't seem to be fazed by anything, and he got himself rewarded with a goal in that game. Tonight he's playing up top, but he can defend. Probably the right back of the future for this Pitt team. Virginia struggling to get the ball out of their own half. Now Pitt's going to have a throw-in.
They're trying to look for Noel. Once again, hands full with Euland.
Pitt's going to have to try to stick in their game plan and not try to press too hard or get out of rhythm. Not force the ball. Continue to build in a productive manner and work for each other.
Quick throw in there from Rosa to Hall. Great ball from Walty. Here's Noah Hall with space against Euland. He's dancing, crosses it through, and Brown sticks out the leg to prevent the cross. Breton Jacquesson was lurking on the backside.
Beautiful through ball to release Noah Hall. He was able to provide the service, but Holden Brown cut it out.
Gorgeous ball by Walty. Noah Hall was kind of a spark plug for the Panthers in the Akron game. He came on and scored a goal in that one when the Panthers really needed it. Went on to draw 3-3 on this field against the Zips. Here's one by Zakulius, and it's an easy cleanup for Vandersaar.
Coach Vidovich knew that there'd be late goals in this one, too. He told us, make sure everyone stays till the end. He'll certainly be hoping for a late goal from his pit team, maybe two.
Looking for Jacquesson on a run. It's against Visa. Jacquesson maintains possession, crossed into the box, just misses the head of Valentin Noel. Another beautiful chance created, but not finished by Pitt.
Couldn't quite make the connection there. Maiufu gets it down the left-hand side, finds Jacquesson, who's able to hold off Vise. Get the ball crossed, but it's just too high for Valentin Noel to connect with.
It's a wonderful idea there by Jacquesson. You saw the quick glance. Trying to put the French Connection stamp on this game.
Jacquesson's just a difference maker. Every time he touches the ball, you think something's going to happen.
Here's Horton. Look at Philip Horton. Goal number two for Horton, number three for his squad. And the Cavaliers are up 3-1.
And that has silenced the crowd here in Pittsburgh. Virginia takes control. There's a turnover here by Maiufu, created by Alfonso. Releases Horton. Vandersaar is off balance, can't do much to stop it. And that's the type of pressure you see. It doesn't let up. The Cavaliers keep coming. And they stick a dagger into Pitt. We'll see if the Panthers have a response to get back in this game, but now it just looks like a mountain to climb for them against a Virginia team that's able to capitalize.
Vandersaar even got a paw on it, but saw the pressure by Alfonso on Maiufu as well right there. Maiufu, not sure where he was even trying to play that ball. Costly mistake. Jay Vidovich told us all about that. He said in the Akron game, multiple mistakes, some brain farts in the Louisville game as well, and there's another one there by his side. And this puts the Panthers in a really tough hole to climb out of with 17 minutes to go. On the Virginia side, Horton, what a game tonight. Two goals, four on the year now, second on the team. Former understudy of Daryl Dike back in 2019 when this Virginia squad went to the national title game. George Gelnavach loves Philip Horton's veteran leadership. He's shown that tonight in a volatile environment here in Pittsburgh. There's a collision after the ball went across the end line. And Holden Brown kind of gave Valentin Noel a shot there.
Well, there's some controversy. The ball looked like it was heading out for a corner. Noel kind of goes over to see it out, maybe. Holden Brown gets himself involved in a play. And I think it's going to be a corner.
It is.
The referee coming all the way over to have a word with his assistant referee, see if he saw anything there.
Here's Noel and Alfonso kind of getting into it in front of the net. Alfonso having words into the ear of Valentin Noel.
Yeah, there's no doubt these guys will be trying to get under each other's skin, force someone to do something out of character. For Pitt, it's important that they stay focused and try to get themselves back on the scoreboard.
This corner goes nowhere. This game is massive for both of these sides. Both teams with 6 points, sitting at 2-1 in the Coastal Division. That's good for second. Duke at 2-0-1, 7 points. They play tomorrow at Wake Forest. So the winner of this match positions themselves, David, for a really good run in the latter half of the ACC season to claim the Coastal Division.
Yeah, I mean, obviously there's always going to be twists and turns, but you know, for the Panthers, you've still got Clemson, Virginia Tech, Duke, and Notre Dame. And I know for Virginia, they've got a murderer's row type schedule, as described by their coach. They've still got to themselves play Duke, Clemson, Wake Forest, and North Carolina in ACC play. So, you know, this isn't going to be the end of the tough games. And we've had exactly what we anticipated tonight. Pitt looking to play quick there.
Here's the schedule for Virginia. Three ranked teams in a row. Still have a matchup with number one Wake Forest looming toward the end of the season. Play Clemson, Wake Forest, and Hofstra all in the span of 7 days. That's a tough stretch of the schedule to play in the latter portion of the season.
Yeah, I think that's something that you see a lot with these ACC teams as well, is what happens in midweek. You know, do you put a full squad out for your midweek game? How much are you able to hedge? How much are you able to get guys experience and still earn wins? How do you minimize mistakes, but, you know, give players room to grow? And so I think all these ACC teams, obviously, they focus on the league and making sure that they're in a position to do as well as possible.
Here's a ball, a good chance for Pitt there. Maiufo looking for Noah Hall, and that was an easy stop for Brown.
Yeah, a little bit too hopeful there. It was just sort of hoping to land on the head of a teammate, but there wasn't anyone there. It was straight to Holden Brown. Maiufo will be a bit disappointed with that, and Pitt's going to need stronger connections to be able to find themselves on the score sheet. And while they've controlled possession in this second half, they haven't dominated the score sheet.
Play continues there as Walty won the ball off of Brown. Or Horton, excuse me.
It has been a while since Pitt lost a regular season game here. They did lose a ACC tournament game to Notre Dame last season. But that was the only blemish since that North Carolina game in 2019.
Virginia trying to be the first team to beat Pitt on its home field in the regular season in 3 years.
And in about the same amount of time, this would be the first time since 2019 that Virginia would win three games in a row. So it's funny, it's sort of shows you what can happen in a period of time like that. Virginia's been down and gotten back up. Pitt's been dominant, and now they're sort of being challenged in a way that they haven't really had to deal with in a few years in terms of coming from behind from 3-1 on their own turf.
Nakasan on a run there, looking for Hall again. Mirkovic, he lines it into the box and cleared out by Virginia. Pitt still pushing here late. Down 3-1. You got to give Virginia credit where it's due, though. Defensively, I feel like they've disrupted enough of this Pitt offense down in the final third of this field tonight, where you know some of those chances that usually Pitt would bang in aren't as clean as they normally are. Pitt with a plus 66 goal differential since 2019 on this field. They've scored multiple goals in almost every single home game. And tonight, that's just hasn't been the case.
Yeah, you hit the nail on the head. I think the chances they've created haven't been as clear-cut. It's been more from just trying to find a connection that isn't there or trying to force something that isn't there. And now as the pressure mounts for them to get back into this, they're going to have to keep their head. For Virginia, keep doing what you're doing. They've got guys back behind the ball. They can sit back, they can defend, clear the ball out, and disrupt Pitt's build-up. Obviously, they're in a position of power right now, the Cavaliers, to be able to see this game out. 12 more minutes. And they can go back to Charlottesville with a massive ACC win, sitting back on top of the Coastal Division.
Pitch is trying to work everything through Jacquesson right now. Virginia will defend. Done a good job of it. Nothing clean once Pitt has approached the 18-yard box. Valentin Noel sinking back into the formation now. Here's Rosa to Hall. Now Almeida. See, just every time Pitt approaches the box, Virginia does such a good job of sinking in, cutting off passing lanes.
And this is where the Virginia 3-5-2, basically a 5-3-2 at this point in time.
A liner toward the goal. What a save there by Brown.
And I see Mirkovic just putting his head down and gutting things out, running the length of the field, going to get that corner, trying to take advantage of every opportunity he can. Finds himself a little bit of space there to get the shot off. It's going in. Brown makes a huge save. Now the clock stopped as Afonso's down.
He's down way behind the play, out at midfield.
Great shot.
Definitely going in.
Great save by the keeper. But, you know, Pitt's best opportunities of the day other than the goal have been the drives from outside. Obviously, Noel's goal came from outside. Mirkovic, that was his second big opportunity from the outside, and they just haven't been able to develop clear goal-scoring opportunities in the box or capitalize on them.
George Gelnavach told us, you know, how much credit did he give to his three backs in their, you know, 3-5-2 formation. Obviously, a ton of credit tonight has to go to Euland. And they don't even have Aiden O'Connor playing right now, which says a lot about their depth at that spot as well. They've had Citron out there tonight. Kapelsberger, he hasn't had his name called a ton tonight, but just solid all around. And Euland, of course, has done amazing work tonight on Valentin Noel and just disrupting things in the box in general. So Ubogu comes on, for Afonso, and Mirkovic will get set to take this corner. Maiufo tried to send that in on a volley. That's a big collision. Foot was in the air. It's a foul called there on Maiufo.
An unfortunate coming together here. Both players just going for the ball. But it's Slavov gets to it first. He gets kicked for his trouble. Virginia wanted the ref to give Maiufo a yellow card, but he didn't. Pitt's really going to have to dig deep to get anything out of this game. And the longer the seconds tick off the clock, the more it plays into Virginia's favor to close it out. They'll be happy to keep pumping it up the field whenever they get possession.
So what have you made tonight, David, of the three backs for Virginia?
Oh, they've been excellent. I mean, you know, they've really stayed together. They've had a good game plan. And even when Pitt's challenged them or given them problems, they've forced them outside. They've had other guys come back from the midfield and support the defensive efforts. So I think they've really been a solid unit, not just the back three, but the five in front of them in terms of their assignments and their movements and making sure that they disrupt Pitt's passing lanes and that there's always bodies on the white shirts to stop them from having much space. And that's why I think you've seen Pitt's best opportunities coming from outside the box.
George Gelnavach told us, he said, you know, I think a 3-5-2 formation is the best type of formation to combat what Jay Vidovich and the Panthers do with their 4-3-3. And, you know, at times tonight, Pitt has possessed and done some things that they've wanted to do, but, you know, we've talked about it the last couple of minutes when It came down to finishing in the final third. It was Virginia who was able to muddy it up just enough. And we know Pitt likes to play clean. Virginia's made this just physical enough to make it an issue for the Panthers.
Yeah, I think that's a challenge when Pitt wants to stay in possession and rotate the ball around and move it around. Sometimes teams just come and they just want to jam that up. And sometimes you can be quite effective in that. And I think Virginia's had a lot of success jamming up Pitt tonight and creating problems. They've brought a lot of energy, dogged pursuit. You see there, every play, they're contesting and challenging Pitt. And I think, they hit Pitt in the mouth early. Pitt responded, but the second goal really turned the game back on its head. And when Horton was able to get the third,
think about how easily it could have been four goals, too, with the Afonso miss on the penalty kick that was awarded.
I did think Afonso didn't have as strong a second half. He really burst on the first half and was explosive, dangerous, switching up sides. A little bit quieter in the second.
Jeremy Verley coming on.
But we knew coming in, Virginia has stifling back line. They've really had success with it. We knew they were athletic. Obviously, maybe missing O'Connor tonight could have hurt them. It didn't. They have enough depth that they're able to just reshuffle a little bit, slide Euland into the middle. And he's had an excellent game tonight.
Noel with space taps it to Noah Hall. Once again, service in with no white shirts around it. This one chipped, and Brown comes up to grab it after it was deflected there by Kappelsberger. So, David, we said all night, you know, Virginia's had a resurgent season here. Missed the tournament the last 2 years, made the previous 24 under George Galinovich. But this team looks primed for a good run here in the ACC and in the postseason.
Yeah, I feel like he knows he's got a high-level squad. I mean, the contests they've already been in and the results that they've gained, you know, certainly they've had some blemishes early in the season, but you look at the body of work tonight, getting their third straight win, if they're able to see this one out, that'd be massive for them, and getting their seventh win on the season would be massive for them. So I think that they're in a really strong position to finish this out and really go from strength to strength in terms of, you know, what this team can do. Who knows? You know, they're as good as anyone. I mean, Pitt's one of the top teams in the country, number 10 team in the country. And for Virginia, if they're able to knock them off, that'll be two straight top 10 teams that they've beaten in the last week. And it'd be tough for them to not get themselves ranked after some wins like that.
Here's Horton looking for a Hattie. Just tipped out there.
Horton with a good opportunity there to try and get himself the third.
Man, he's got a nose for the goal tonight, doesn't he?
Well, he's a really strong player, and he's got a head of steam. Vandesar makes a save, but Horton's had a great game. He'll be extremely pleased with that. Euland gives it a whack up the field. We'll see how quickly Pitt can get it forward. One of the things I was interested in researching this game was Coach Galinovich's playing career. You know, All-American himself at the University of Virginia. Scored 16 goals his freshman year in 1983. Played with John Harkes. And the other thing that I learned about Coach Galinovich was his role with the U.S. national team and helping to take the 2002 World Cup team to the quarterfinals. So he's certainly got great coaching experience, obviously playing for Bruce Arena, taking over from Bruce Arena. He knows exactly what this game's about. And while he may be a taskmaster, he's got a well-drilled Virginia team here that is looking to pull off another big road upset in the ACC.
Jack Hassan trying to do something here at the end of this match. They're going to give him a corner out of it. You just think about the excellence of Virginia's program. 39-year postseason streak up until 2019, 7 national titles, 13 college cups, and only 2 head coaches, David, in the program since 1978. With Bruce Arena, George Gelnavach. Sorry, I was mistaken on the corner. They're going to give him a free kick from that spot. Mirkovic now. A liner, tried to curl it in back post, couldn't do it.
We did see Pitt score 2 goals in about a minute and a half during the Akron game. They were down 2-0 in the first half and scored 2 in about the last 90 seconds of the half to take it in at 2-2. But I'm not sure that they can uncork such success tonight. Virginia stingy D as advertised. And there's nobody dogging it on this Virginia team. They are going to see this thing out, pursue every ball.
Well, with the 3 goals tonight, David, Virginia has surpassed their goal total from a year ago. 24 now this season, 23 all of last year. The 24 this year, good for 2nd in the conference. So the issue the last couple of years was, you know, obviously roster turnover, all those things, but they just couldn't score the ball. And they seem to have solved that problem this season with guys like Ubogu and Afonso. And then you get production from the back like Reese Miller, Philip Horton tonight with a couple.
Yeah, you didn't see a lot of weakness in this Virginia team. They came to play from the first kickoff. Took it to Pitt, took the game to the Panthers. And while Pitt's responded, they haven't had enough moments. They haven't had enough consistency to be able to win this game tonight, and they haven't created enough quality scoring opportunities. But they keep trying. Holden Brown again, just able to snuff it out. Brown, Euland at the back, Kapelsberger, they've all been really strong back there. Citron's come on and contributed valuable minutes.
Pitt has had the better of the series in recent years. Unbeaten in their last 5 against Virginia. Before that, it was all Virginia, 7-0-1. Virginia comes in here and settles the score. Here's Noel.
Just too many blue shirts back in the box, forcing Pitt away from the goal. Bodies back.
Under a minute to go here. Goal kick for Virginia, and they're going to take their sweet time. Bench starting to feel it a little bit. So hard to win on the road in the ACC. So hard to win at Pitt. Panthers 26-1 on their home field since 2019. This would be only their first regular season loss since October 4th of 2019. Pitt was sporting a +66 goal differential on this field coming into tonight. And they've now allowed 2 straight opponents, Akron and Virginia, to score 3 goals on this field, which hadn't been done in the previous 21 matches. Just astounding by Virginia. What a performance for the Cavaliers to come in. Knock off number 10 Pitt for their 2nd straight top 10 victory. Virginia is in the lead in the ACC Coastal standings.
Great win for the Cavaliers, well deserved. They earned it. 90 hard minutes. Pitt stunned for the 2nd week in a row.
Three-game win streak for the first time in 3 years. Pitt, their first regular season home loss in 3 years. What a performance by that guy, Andreas Euland, the captain. Just gobbled everything up on the backside, gave Valentin Noel everything he could handle. 4 goals in the match. Let's take a look at them here. started off early, David.
Yeah, going back to the beginning, this was in the first minute. Virginia just comes out and punches Pitt in the mouth. Philip Horton with the goal. Later in the first half, Valentin Noel is able to drag Pitt back into this game with a beautifully placed effort. But in the second half, Virginia takes the lead again. Well-worked build-up play, and the young Miller is able to capitalize. And the game ends right here. Philip Horton is able to capitalize on a turnover. 3-1, and it was just too much for Pitt to come back to. Virginia too strong at the back defensively, and they were able to get the goals they need to get the win.
So you look at the updated standings right now, and you see Virginia with 9 points, 3-1 in the conference. Two massive consecutive wins against top 10 teams. Last week on the road against Syracuse, this week on the road against the Pitt Panthers. Duke will play at Wake Forest tomorrow night, so that'll also have a say in the Coastal Division against number one Wake Forest.